Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Although this video does not show the inside of real people, viewers who are sensitive to the life sciences may be disturbed. We suggest that any viewers who are sensitive to the life sciences have an adult who is not sensitive to this content. Watch this video first to be sure it is suitable for that viewer. Our skeletal system is the collection of more than 200 bones in our bodies. The largest bone in our bodies is the thigh bone, which is also called the femur. The smallest bones in our bodies are the three in each ear, which help us hear. Our muscular system helps us move ourselves or move things. In some people, we can see each muscle because their muscles are so big, but we all have the same number of muscles that are in the same places, and they do the same jobs. To demonstrate how muscles in the arms work, we will use this simple model. To bend the elbow, we contract the biceps muscle that makes the muscle bulge up. The word contract means to shorten a muscle. To straighten the elbow, we relax the biceps muscle and contract the triceps muscle. These people are exercising just the biceps or the triceps muscles, so we can see each muscle contracting individually. By contracting, muscles actively move a joint. That is why muscles are in pairs that are on the front and back of many joints, so we can bend or straighten a joint. Here is an example with our knees. To straighten the knee, we contract the big muscles on the front of our thigh bones, which are called the quadriceps. To bend our knees, we contract the hamstring muscles that are behind the thigh bone. Our brain plus the nerves throughout our body are called the nervous system. Our brain is safely protected inside our skulls. Our spinal cord runs from the base of our brains to the bottom of our backs and is protected inside the cage-like structure of the backbones. Another name for backbones are vertebrae. Our nerves are like wires since they carry signals very fast between our brain or spinal cord and every other part of our body. Of all the things that scientists have studied on Earth and even in the rest of the universe, one of the most complicated things is the human brain. There are many different parts. We'll name just three regions and we'll note just a few details. The brainstem, shown in green, helps in many of our automatic functions. For example, it controls how fast our hearts beat, how fast we breathe. It helps us wake up and stay awake. The cerebellum plays a major role in our coordination, such as being able to walk and play sports. The cerebral cortex makes up almost the entire brain in humans. We use it for thinking, talking, processing the images our eyes receive, and so much more. One of the reasons humans are the smartest animals is because our cerebral cortex is so big compared with other animals. Motor nerves carry signals from our brains to our muscles so that we can walk or run or do something very complicated like playing an instrument. Sensory nerves carry signals from our skin, ears, and other parts back to our brain. The digestive system helps us get energy and nutrition from food. The first part is the mouth, since that is where food enters the digestive tract. When we swallow, food goes down the esophagus, commonly called the food tube, and enters the stomach. The stomach has acidic juice that kills many germs that may have been on the food. From there, the food goes into the small intestine. It's about 15 feet long, and inside this long tube, our food is broken into tiny nutrients. Depending on what we're eating, sometimes the body needs to use some special juices to dissolve the food before it leaves the small intestine. For example, fatty food like ice cream may need a little bile, which is stored in the gallbladder and squirted into the small intestine when needed. The pancreas makes enzymes and puts them into the small intestine. Those enzymes also break the food into small nutrients. Once the food is broken into small nutrients, those nutrients pass through the wall of the small intestine and go to a large vein that takes the nutrients to the liver. The reason digested food goes to the liver first is because the liver removes toxins that could be in food or drinks. After nutrients leave the liver, they go into our main blood circulation and are taken to the rest of the body where we use them for energy and growth. There are some things in our food that we cannot digest, such as fiber. An example of fiber is the pulp from an orange. This is in contrast to the juice part of the orange which we can digest. Fiber is not absorbed by the small intestine, so it continues down the digestive tract, where it is stored by the large intestine until we excrete it. Other names for the large intestine is the colon and large bowel. This rubber raft is moving, even though the people are not paddling and there is no motor on the raft. Rats like this move because the water in the river is moving. This is the same way that our circulatory system works. Our blood is like the water. The walls of our blood vessels are like the banks of the river. And all the important things that are being transported in our blood are like the rafts on this river. We don't have tiny boats with motors moving things around our blood vessels. Instead, nutrients and other things float in our blood, and the blood carries it around the body as the blood is pumped everywhere. We can count how many times our heart beats in a minute, and that is called our pulse. Some smart watches display this, but we can also feel our pulse and count how many beats there are in a minute. There are two major types of blood vessels in the body: the arteries, which are colored red in this image, and the veins, which are colored blue. Arteries carry blood away from the heart, and veins carry blood towards the heart. They are similar to how freeways work since, like freeway traffic, the flow goes in only one direction. For example, if the heart of the city is here, then this side is the artery and this side is the vein. Blood is pumped from the heart through arteries, then travels through capillaries where it gives nutrients and oxygen to various tissues, and picks up waste products from those tissues. Then the blood enters the veins and is returned to the heart, which pumps it to the lungs. In the lungs, the blood picks up oxygen and releases the waste product, carbon dioxide. Then the blood returns to the heart and repeats the cycle. We can measure how much oxygen the arteries are carrying using a pulse oximeter like this one. The other number is the pulse, which is the number of times the heart is beating per minute. The respiratory system is the formal name for our lungs and our airways. Like our hearts, our lungs are fragile, so they are protected inside the rib cage. The formal name for the windpipe is the trachea. In addition to taking in oxygen, the lungs are how we exhale a waste product called carbon dioxide. This is a molecule of water, and this is a molecule of carbon dioxide, along with a carbon dioxide sensor. These are the two most famous molecules we will study in K-12 science. Right now, the carbon dioxide reading in the room is in the mid-400s, so it's low. When the man brings the carbon dioxide sensor close to his nose and breathes on it, the reading starts to rise. That's because we all have carbon dioxide in our breath. Our bodies make carbon dioxide as a waste product when we turn nutrients into energy. This muscle is called the diaphragm, and it is a major muscle we use to breathe in and out. To show how the diaphragm works, let's look at how this device works. By pulling on the plunger, we increase the space inside the device, and this will then generate a suction that we can use to pull out the colored water. By pushing on the plunger, we can reduce the space inside the device, and it pushes out the water. In this model, the glass is like our chest wall, the red balloons are like our lungs, the tiny hole at the top is like our windpipe, and the rubber sheet on the bottom is like our diaphragm muscle. By contracting or relaxing the diaphragm muscle, we can increase or decrease the space inside the chest, and in turn, make the lungs inhale or exhale air. The lungs are more complicated than simple balloons. They are filled with airways that lead to tiny air sacs called alveoli. Those sacs are covered with capillaries. As the blood goes past the sacs, the blood gives up the waste product carbon dioxide into the sacs, and then picks up fresh oxygen. Our kidneys are located towards our lower backs, so they are protected by the rib cage. Their job is to remove some waste products from the blood, which we then excrete. Our immune system helps protect us from infections. You may have noticed some lumps under your jaw if you have a sore throat. Those are called lymph nodes and get bigger during an infection. Then they go down when the infection is gone. In the left upper part of our abdomen is our spleen, which is also a key part of our immune system. There are other groups of organs that work together as a system which help us do various things to stay healthy. But this is an introduction to the basic ones. Here's a review of what we covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.